Hey guys, what's up? This is Will, and it's been a long time. It's 2021. This video is gonna be me talking to my future self, kind of explaining where I'm at now, and kind of just hoping where I go in the future, and hopefully if my future self is alive and looks back at this video years from now and sees the stuff that I was saying, maybe he's in a better place, and I hope that he is. If he's not and he's still in the same place, I just hope that he gets the power and the strength to do better. Anyways, hi, my name is Will. It is December 7th, 2021. I am 34 years old. And this is kind of where I'm at now. Now, from retrospectively, looking at my life through the lens of remembering and nostalgia, this time is probably a very great time from a third person perspective, when you can't see or hear what's going on in here. My life is not terrible. My life is actually very good. Me and my boyfriend had moved into our own apartment in October of this year, and everything has been fine. I now work at a job that's not office max. I now work at a restaurant as a dishwasher. I get to listen to music all the time, and I love that. I absolutely love it. I love it. I think my schedule is mostly consistent. I've been playing video games lately. I've been playing video games and enjoying it. Been playing the PlayStation 5, the Nintendo Switch, which is going to be interesting to be like, oh, 10 years from now, if I watch this, I'll be like, oh my God, it's so old. I remember that. It is 2021, which means that we're in a new decade and you're not looking so good right now. You gained a lot of weight. You're definitely at the biggest that you've ever been. On top of that, you're not shaving. You don't get your hair cut. You avoid people like the plague. You're kind of alone. And there's days where you absolutely love it, and there's days where you hate it. But at the end of the day, it's a good time. I don't know. You feel so disconnected from your family right now. Like, you're not connected with your mother, you're not connected with your sister, even though you guys all live in the same apartment complex. You are just kind of just staying at home, and you're not really doing anything. You quit the course, you quit your therapist, you quit your psychologist, or psychiatrist. I don't even know what the difference, I don't know. One person who gave me medicine and one person that heard me talk. You got rid of all that. You no longer are part of the chorus. You're no longer part of the Q-tones. You're just basically a shell. You attempted to go to school, but you didn't go. So mental health wise, you're not great. Body wise, you're not happy. You're not great. In terms of your relationship status, you are in a very amazing relationship, but you're having issues that you're working out. And the issue that you're working out is that your relationship is open. And though rules have been established and they're being respected, you still have issues with it some days. So some days you kind of go a little crazy, or you get a little sad or whatever. So there's that. And some days you're perfectly fine and you're cool with it and you're good. But you also have a tendency of comparing yourself to your partner. And because you do that, you get angry. And since you don't have people to vent out with like you used to in the last decade, you kind of tend to just kind of take it out on him, but not like in a bad way. You've been catching yourself lately in terms of noticing what you're doing. But other than that, that's it. But as far as everything else goes, you smoke weed now. You don't do it as much. You had a very bad trip this year, which was very, very interesting. I don't know. Where would I like to see you at now? If I could look into the future right now and see where you're at, I would like you to be in a healthier place. Like you're in a healthier body. I would like to see you with more confidence. I would like to see you financially in a really good place where you're not struggling. I would like to see you potentially married, potentially in a very happy relationship, and you're doing good and you're doing wonderful. I just don't want you to be down in the gutter. I know that our brain, unfortunately, this is going to follow us and haunt us to the end of time. I just want you to look at this and see that everything is a learning experience, that don't rush things because things may take forever for you to get them. You may be 90, and currently I don't have an idea of what I want to do. I just hope that if you're watching this back, that you have an idea of what you want to do. I don't want you to feel sad. I want you to be happy. You lost a lot of people. I want this virus to be gone. But because this virus is here, even if they were to find a cure for it, life is not the same anymore. People are hostile. Things are starting to get more automatic. People are more disconnected than they've ever been. It's not a great time. And especially since you're creative, you are going through a motivational thing at this time. You have no motivation to do anything with your life. You're kind of just lazy and you play video games whenever you can. Sometimes you can't even do that. It's a rough time. That's all I can say. I would love to be traveling the world. I would like to perform again. I would like to be healthy and look in the mirror and actually be proud of what I am. But I know that this is me talking, and I hope that you prove me wrong. But I know myself. And if I know myself, you're either dead or you're worse off than you were. You sabotaged something. You've took something that was perfectly okay, and because you allowed the inner demons of your thoughts to take over, you sabotaged everything. I don't want that to be the scenario, so please, I hope that we're just in a better place, you and I. I need to be in a better place. I want to enjoy the time as it happens. Do you like what I mean is that I want to enjoy the present. I don't want to worry about the future. I don't want to have to worry about the past. I just want to focus on now and appreciating what I have now. But it's so hard for me to do that. And I hope that you have the wisdom to control that. I just don't want you to be sad. I mean, I understand that you're going to have sad days from here on out. There's going to be times where you mess up. There's going to be times where you're going to do things that you wish that you never did. There's going to be things that you wish you did more. There's going to be things that you're never going to feel enough or whatever. There's going to be times where probably, if this goes the worst case scenario route, you're going to look back on this video and be like, damn, I wish I was at least that skinny, you know, because that's what I say about myself 10 years ago. So mentally, I'm not in the best place. You know, I'm okay today, but mentally, I struggle. I suffer. But hopefully, you don't. Hopefully, your family's still alive. Hopefully, you have a lot of wonderful people in your life. Hopefully, you're a little bit more social. Hopefully, you're doing music or something creative, something that makes you happy. Hopefully, you're finding something and that you're just not settling. Anyways, I want to try to be better and to my future self, I hope you are better. I hope that once I hit your timeline, that I could look back at this video and say, wow, damn. I just don't want to live my life with regret. I don't want to feel like I wasted time. I don't want to feel like that. And that's what I'm feeling like. I feel like I'm wasting time. Even though I'm doing everything as correct as I possibly can. I'm not in financial ruin. I'm not in a thing. I'm making choices. And to be honest, it's this virus that makes me think that I can't do certain things because it's here. And the media has made me hate the public. I'm sick and tired of looking at TikTok and stuff. So I also hope that you're like on social media more, maybe, and that you're, you know, actually taking pictures and doing things. I just hope that you're just in a financially better place. There's so many things I wish. I just wish nothing but the best for you. And also, I want you to pass the wisdom that you learn in the next coming years. And give that to the next future self. To the person in your 50s. Anyways, this has been Will, and I love you.